best marriage, the best example to learn from is the marriage of Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib and Fatima al-Zahra alayhim as-salam. Maybe the most successful marriage of all time. Look at how simple it began. Imam Ali alayhi as-salam, he's a single man. Ma'ad ibn Jabal and Umar ibn al-Khattab, these two companions, they come to Imam Ali, they tell him, Ya Ali, why don't you propose your cousin Fatima? Go and marry Fatima al-Zahra alayhi as-salam. Imam Ali is a poor man. He doesn't have a house, he doesn't have anything. So he's shy to go and propose, and he doesn't even have a place for her. So he's hesitant, they encourage him, until he goes and proposes to Fatima al-Zahra. He asks, Rasulullah, I want to marry Fatima. Now, Rasulullah, the hadith says, he goes to Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, and he tells her, Imam Ali, Ali ibn Abi Talib has come, and he has asked your hand, he wants to marry you. Now the hadith says Fatima did not ask any question. How much does he make? What does he work? Where does he live? What's his house? She knew this is Ali ibn Abi Talib. This is the leader, the commander of the mu'mineen, of the faithful. And this is enough. This is all a person needs in order for them to live a happy life. The hadith says she just stayed quiet. She didn't say yes because she was shy to say yes. And the Holy Prophet, he was happy. He said, sukutuha iqraruha. The fact that she stayed quiet here means she's okay. Rasulullah accepted. And look at the dowry of Imam Ali alayhi salam, al-mahar. He goes, he asks Imam Ali, what do you have to give as a dowry to Fatima? Imam Ali says, I have three things. I have my shield, I have my sword, and my camel. That's all I have. You choose whatever you want. The Holy Prophet says, you need your camel and sword, but you could sell your shield. He goes and he sells his shield for 500 dirhams, and he gives it to Rasulullah. 500 dirhams, brothers and sisters, is equivalent anywhere from $500 to $1,000, today's currency. This is the dowry of Sayyidah Nisa al-Alameen. 500 to 1,000. That's all. And she was happy. She was content about that. That's all that Imam Ali alayhi salam gave. And you find some marriages today, I've seen some marriages, for a few weeks there's negotiations between the man and the usually the families on how much. The family of the girl keep on going up, 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 and the family of the man keep on trying to, you know, getting a discount. It's as if they're selling, it's as if it's a transaction, it's as if it's a business deal. That's how they value their daughter. It's just based on money. I attended one wedding, aqd, and the mahar, subhanallah, the dowry of the girl was $1 million, $1 million US. And I heard a few months after that, I heard there was problems and they got a divorce. And you know, there was tension when I was there because the family of the man didn't like that, but the family of the woman had put that as a, you know, as a condition. You won't get our daughter until you give $1 million, as if they're selling her. But what these people don't understand is Fatima alayhi salam, who's our role model, her mahar was just 500 dirhams, let's say $1,000. Is my daughter better than Fatima? Why should I expect my daughter to have a mahar that's higher than Fatima? If I'm a girl, am I better than Fatima or Fatima's better than me? Of course Fatima is better. If Fatima accepted such a low mahar, shouldn't I follow in her footsteps? Who do we follow? Who's our role model? This is the important question we have to ask ourselves. That Fatima alayhi salam is our role model. And the hadith of Rasulullah says, خَيْرُ نِسَاءُ أُمَّتِي أَقَلُّهُنَّ مَهْرًا. The best women of my nation are those that ask the least of the dowries. So anyway, he gives his shield as a mahar. And then he asks him, do you have a house? He says, no, I have nowhere. So Rasulullah, there was a wealthy man from the Ansar. His name was Al-Haritha. His name was Al-Haritha ibn al-Nu'man. Rasulullah, he knew him, he had some extra houses, so he asked him if Imam Ali could borrow, either rent or borrow your house for the first few months or years until he's able to prepare his own house. He gives him the house, And Imam Ali alayhi salam lives with Fatima alayhi salam. And they had the most humble of furniture. All they owned in that house was a blanket made of sheepskin, a few pillows, a mattress, and a few utensils for the kitchen, like handmill, jugs and some other stuff. This is all that Fatima alayhi salam, Sayyidatu Nisa'il Alameen, the greatest woman of all time, this is all that her house contained. But did she ever whine? Did she ever complain? Never. Fatima was happy because she knew that these stuff do not matter. They will not bring happiness, only short-term happiness. She's the wife of Ali ibn Abi Talib. What an honor it is to be the wife of Ali, and what an honor it is to be the husband of Fatima. Both ways. The hadith says that some women of Quraysh during the time of Fatima, they came and they began to insult Fatima. They would tell her, look at what your father did to you. He let you marry Ali, such a poor man. He's not rich, he's not wealthy. And those back then, the Arabs, they were all about money. You would value someone based on his money. So they would make fun of Fatima and insult her because she married Imam Ali alayhi salam. But yet you find Imam Ali and Fatima, they led the best life, the most successful life. Rasulullah came to Fatima and he told her, Ya Fatima, do not care about what these women tell you. Your husband is Ali ibn Abi Talib. He is the best creation of Allah after me. And then he begins to speak about the virtues of Ali ibn Abi Talib. And that's why you see they led the most successful marriage. And this hadith from Imam Ali alayhi salam shows you, it summarizes how beautiful their marriage was. The hadith of Imam Ali, he says, after Fatima alayhi salam died, he says, فَوَاللَّهِ مَا أَغْضَبْتُهَا وَلَا أَكْرَهْتُهَا عَلَىٰ أَمْرٍ حَتَّى قَبْضَهَا اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. He says, وَاللَّهِ, I never angered Fatima throughout the years that I lived with her. I never angered her. I never forced her to do anything. This is on one side. And on the other side, he says, وَلَا أَغْضَبَتْنِي وَلَا عَصَتْ لِي أَمْرًا. And on the other hand, she never angered me, nor did she ever disrespect me or she disobeyed me. It was mutual respect. And then he says, وَلَقَدْ كُنْتُ أَنظُرُ إِلَيْهَا فَتَنْكَشِفْ عَنِّي الْهُمُومُ وَالْأَحْزَانِ. He says, when I would look at Fatima alayhi salam, if I had any stress, if I had any agony, he says, I would forget all my stress. He says, I would forget all my agony. As soon as I see Fatima, I forget all my problems. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, spend millions of dollars on your wedding. You could never buy that feeling. That when you look at your spouse, you feel that content. You feel that happiness. And it's as if all your stress has gone away. All your problems have disappeared. This can only be bought through iman and taqwa. Through faith and through manners. The hadith says that after they got married, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he grabbed the hand of Fatima and he placed it in the hand of Imam Ali. And he told Imam Ali, Ya Ali, hadihi wadi'ati. He told her, this is my wadi'a, this is my trust. Take care of my trust, Ya Ali. Akhadha al-imam. أخذ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله بيد فاطمة ووضعها في يد علي وقال له يا علي هذه وديعتي عندك فاحفظها يا علي ثم أخذ بيد علي ووضعه في يد فاطمة وقال لفاطمة يا فاطمة هذا علي زوجك فاحترميه واحفظي حقوقه. Rasulullah took the hand of Fatima, he placed it in the hand of Ali, and he told him, Ya Ali, take care of my daughter Fatima. She is my trust in your hands. Do not let anyone bother Fatima alayhi salam. Do not let anyone disrespect Fatima. Do not let anyone do anything that upsets or angers Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam.